The Drive on your local radio station. We are ESPN Blacksburg, and a good Thursday afternoon to all of you. Wayne, you're an animal. 866-961-1430 is the number, 866-961-1430. You can also text us. The number is exactly the same. Nathan Brennan is in the other studio taking your calls. The Reverend Miss Domina Steele, girl, the Andrew Alex is sitting across from me working on what could potentially win him a Virginia Association of Broadcasters Award for Video of the Year. Very excited for this to come out. Is it up now?
Yeah, really bringing the iMovie skills back out. Right. You know, very simple. I think the beauty of it is the pan picture of Nathan. Today is a good day. It really is.
I am currently retweeting this from ESPN Blacksburg and from my own account so that everyone has
like I said on Twitter, I have no regrets.
I will have to I know you would take that as a compliment, Wayne. I will have to watch this. I've been hearing the production over there. But before
it's working hard today.
I you know what? I can get behind that. Before we do any of that though, let's do a little of this.
Can't keep my hands to myself. No matter how hard I'm trying to.
Scott Nason.
Scott Nason.
Scott Nason joining us today. How are you, my friend?
Paul, I'm doing wonderful. A pretty exciting day for me and the Nason family. As you know, my oldest son, Vance, he's about to start in his first ever high school basketball game.
Oh,
on the freshman team here locally, and they have their first game at 6 o'clock. So pretty exciting. Hard to believe he's already at that stage in his life, a ninth grader, but looking forward to that. And, of course, talking to you about some sports.
I remember the night he was born. Speaking of which, Wayne in Ohio wants to know if you already have your plans in place for Valentine's Day coming up this Sunday, Scott. Maybe sneak one past the goalie, if you know what we're saying.
I'm hoping to sneak the whole team out past the goalie on that one. So, yeah, it certainly will be a fun Valentine's Day here at the Nathan household.
Fun, I can imagine. Yeah, that's a great way to describe it.
All right, Scott, we were just talking about this a few minutes ago, and we're talking about Sam Darnold. And Darnold, apparently, they're saying, is going to demand a little bit of a haul if the Jets are to trade him. You look at that completion percentage over the last 3 years, that record, and it's not like he's been super impressive. But on the other side of it, there's the Ryan Tannehill theory. The theory, you take the quarterback, you place him somewhere else, and he'll thrive. Do you buy into that? Do you think Darnold has a lot of worth right now, or would you not give up a lot for him if you were a general manager?
You know, he's a big question mark. And you go back to last offseason, there were only two teams that went after Tom Brady. The team that got him, obviously, won last week, as predicted by me.
That's true.
On this show, with almost the margin. I just wanted to point that out from the outset. But, you know, Darnold was not put in a great situation. Would I bet the farm on him right now? No, I think I would go for a few players in the NFL draft if you have the capability to, you know, to trade up, or you have the capability to make that pick. I'm not real sold on Darnold. I mean, could he go into another situation and do well? Yes. Do I think he will? Not so sure. So I'm not big on Sam Darnold. He's really shown me nothing outside of that first game against Detroit, where it looked like he was going to be the next GOAT after torching the Lions in his first start. I'm not buying Sam Darnold right now. I could be wrong, but right now he doesn't have the resume, and I think the skill set to prove it.
Scott Nason, I want to take you back in time to September 8th of 2020. We all know that 2020 was a tough year for everyone, but I don't think anyone could have predicted it would have been this tough.
I'm telling you, the Buccaneers, you can go save this right now, because when this take is correct, I want to make sure that I get the credit I deserve. The Buccaneers, and arguably the most difficult division in football, will not make the playoffs.
Scott Nason. Do you have any words of encouragement for young Nathan Brennan? We did what he told us to do. We saved that sound clip and
he got the credit for what he said.
He really did. Yeah. Do you have any words of wisdom for him?
Yes. Don't bet against the Tom Brady team. Period. That's the words of wisdom right now. I mean, obviously, at the time, you know, not having an off season and you know looking at where Tampa was last year. Even during the season, when they had that tough November and the Buccaneers were 7-5, but you could just see over the end of the regular season and obviously what they did in the playoffs that this team was getting better, and it was all on the defensive end. Yes, Brady did amazing things, and you know their offense was good. Fournette was, to me, the big X factor in the entire playoffs, kind of putting them over the hump. But it was all about that defense and what Todd Bowles did with that defense was nothing short of spectacular. And so, hey, you know what, Nathan? You put your money where your mouth was, and I give you credit for that. We'll look next September for more great predictions from you, sir.
he's going to predict it again. That's my prediction.
I will do the same exact thing. I can promise you that. Until it works.
Until it works or he retires in 2042.
Mark my word. There's no way he comes back at 67 years old.
Hey, Scott, we were just talking about the Buccaneers, and you mentioned that defense. It was built through the draft. Mm-hmm. Buccaneers general manager says every year they just go for the best player available, regardless of position. They didn't necessarily reach after, I guess no one thought Jameis Winston was a reach at the time, but they did pick Jameis Winston. After that, best player available year after year after year. You look at McShay's mock draft this year, and they have the four top quarterbacks on the board going 1-4. Do you believe that is what teams should be doing this year? Do you believe that these quarterbacks in this class are at that much of a premium, or do you think that it's just going to leave a lot of good players and a lot of other valuable positions available for the teams in picks 5 through 15?
I think it will because, obviously Trevor Lawrence, I think, is, I wouldn't say a sure thing. I don't want to go on record and say that, but he's a pretty solid pick at 1. And then you have, I think of all the four main quarterbacks, Zach Wilson to me might be the second best out of that. I'm not sold on Justin Fields. I use Paul's Ohio State quarterback theory on that one. And we just don't know enough about Trey Lance because we haven't seen him other than some promotional videos. So these days, quarterbacks in the draft are the hot topic and some work, some don't. But that again, that leaves, players, at the best position or best available that could go to some of these teams that pick, in the high parts of the draft, at 7, 8, or 9. The Lions are part of that, and we'll see what they do. I don't think they're going to go quarterback, it seems, with getting Goff. But, yeah, it's a question mark. I think there's a couple pretty sure things in that quarterback draft. I'm not sold on Fields. He's going to have to prove me wrong on that one. And we just don't know enough about Trey Lance. I mean, he has the skill set, but, again, he hasn't played for a while. So it's hard to say. But Tampa certainly did things the right way, and they were rewarded with the Super Bowl last Sunday.
We talk about this all the time here, kind of off the air, and all of us, I think, are in agreement that Penei Sewell, the offensive tackle out of Oregon, seems to be the guy that, from a standpoint of everywhere else, not in the quarterback position, but everywhere else, can't miss. When you look at the
Jets... Best player in the draft, not named Trevor Lawrence.
Yeah, exactly. When you look at the Jets right now, and the fact that they've got Becton at one tackle, if they put Sewell at the other tackle, does that not make the most sense for the Jets?
Well, I think so. And you look at, winning a Super Bowl, you need the flashy quarterback, and you need a good defense, but you need line play, and that's what we saw. And you guys were talking about it a couple weeks before the Super Bowl as far as Kansas City and having some starters off that line, and look what happened. The Tampa Bay dominated both lines in that game, and that's what won them the game. And, Brady didn't have to, have heroics and throw for 400 yards. And so, if you're going to build a team, you want to build it at the lines and both sides of the ball, and the Jets certainly could do that. So it's going to be interesting. We got a few months before, I guess only a couple months now before the draft. There's going to be some jockeying for position. I'm sure some big trades, I hope at least, because it makes it more exciting to talk about it. But, you certainly want to start with the line. That's where you want to build, in my opinion, if you want to have a contending and championship team.
New report coming out of the butthole of North America, Cleveland, Ohio, says that Odell Beckham Jr., that was for Jimmy Cleveland, Odell Beckham Jr. could potentially be Tampa Bay bound. Now, Scott, if you're Tampa Bay at this point, you've dealt with a head case that is Antonio Brown and got him back to playing good football. We know Gronk is a head case, but not in a bad way. Gronk is just kind of a meathead. Do you really want to add Odell Beckham Jr. to that group of receivers, or does this just feel like this is a recipe for disaster?
You know, I think if anywhere it could work, it would be there with Tom Brady. I mean, obviously with Antonio Brown, he wasn't a key to their success, but he certainly wasn't a hindrance either, as he caught a touchdown in the Super Bowl and did decent when he was in there. But, you know, Beckham's a different sort of breed there, and boy, you'd have a lot of personalities on that team. But if there's one place that it would probably work, it would be Tampa. I don't think it would work many other places. I'm not buying into this too much. I don't see a whole lot of gain from Tampa's perspective. I mean, I don't know how they're not the favorite next year, even though a couple teams in the early odds are above them, Green Bay and Kansas City. I don't think this is going to happen, but if it does happen, the one place it could work would be Tampa.
You mentioned Green Bay, obviously. Aaron Rodgers came out and played at a all-pro level, winning the MVP for this season. Do you see any chance that he doesn't remain in Green Bay? There has been talks. Teams have been calling about a possible trade. Do you see any scenario where he is no longer a Packer?
I don't see a scenario this upcoming season. I think after that, all bets are off. You know, Aaron Rodgers has done a lot in Green Bay, but, mm-hmm. you know, they haven't taken that next step. I mean, his record in NFC Championship games is not good. There's some friction between him and LaFleur, which was evident in that NFC Championship game. And with Green Bay taking a quarterback in the last draft and kind of have somebody waiting in the fold there, I think Aaron Rodgers can write his own ticket. And certainly, if Matt Stafford was that well-coveted, as well as apparently Sam Darnold might be, you certainly got to think Aaron Rodgers is going to be able to go pretty much wherever he wants. So I think he's in Green Bay this upcoming season. I don't see him leaving that early. But after next season, I think all bets are off, and I think Aaron Rodgers goes to greener pastures. Obviously, Tom Brady kind of has the blueprint for that right now with his success, so I'm sure other quarterbacks may be taking note and wanting to do the same thing.
Scott, standing here today, Thursday after the Super Bowl, we don't know what's going to happen in the draft. We don't know what's going to happen in free agency. Give me the team that you believe is going to make that big jump to become a playoff contender, to become a Super Bowl contender, and tell me a team that you think is going to take a major step backwards.
Team that's going to take a step. I think Indianapolis, I know you're going to like this one, if they can find the right quarterback via the draft or trade, I think they have enough potential there with that defense and a solid running game to make some noise. So I'm going to put them as maybe one of the teams.
Boo.
Yeah, I know. I figured one person would like that. A team that might step down. I think maybe New Orleans, you know, not having Drew Brees and, you know, I don't know what they're going to be doing at the quarterback position. I think they might be one team that might be taking a couple notches back. I think they probably would make the playoffs, but I don't know. I think that's a team maybe that's hit its peak and they're on the downward slide. We'll have to see. But those are the two teams I can think of right now that would be going one direction up and the other direction a bit down.
He's always got the potent takes, ladies and gentlemen. It's Scott Nason. Scott, how do our listeners get more great content from you? When are you guys dropping another show?
We're doing another show on Monday. It's called The Game. You can find it at thegamesportshow.com or thegamesportshow.podbean.com.
As always, my man, we appreciate you. Look forward to chatting with you next week. You take care of yourself.
You guys as well. Enjoyed the, I don't know if it's warm down there, but it's bitter cold up here, so hopefully it's warmer where you're at. Have a good one. I'll talk to you next week.
All right, Scotty, take care. A little bit warmer, not really. When we come back, four questions. You got to get three of them today. It's The Drive.
Get the ultimate competitive advantage without the pesky side effects and legal issues of PEDs. This is your mega dose of sports adrenaline.
ESPN Blacksburg, AM 810, FM 93.1, 97.1, and ESPNBlacksburg.com.